Let's look at an example on how to divide fractions in the real world. I bought this blueberry streusel bread to take to a little get-together with a couple of friends for Thanksgiving. But my 3-year-old son really wanted some of it, and I can't just tell him no. So I cut off 1/4 of the pumpkin bread so that he could have some for breakfast over the next couple of days. But now I'm worried that I won't have enough for my friends. Right now, I have 3/4 of the blueberry bread, and I need to share it with my 3 friends, and me, of course. I need to figure out how big a piece everyone would get, and if that's big enough, or if I should go ahead and buy another loaf. Right now, I only have 3 pieces, so that's not going to work to share with 4 people. So what could I do? We would need to divide. I'd need to cut it up into smaller pieces that are even. So if I cut it up long ways in 4 sections, then everyone would have the same amount. So let's see. One person would get 3 pieces out of 16 possible pieces because we have to count the missing portion of the bread that Wes will eat. So even though we only see 12 pieces, we still have to think about that other piece of 1/4 that we removed earlier. So I went ahead and drew our berry bread so that we could get an idea of what a model of that represents. But remember, I got rid of 1/4 and I gave it to my son Wes because he was starving. So I actually only have 3/4 to share with my friends whenever I go to that Thanksgiving party. So if I'm going to share this pumpkin bread, we got to figure out, is it enough? So I drew a little picture to see how we would show what we already did with the berry bread in real life. So we'd actually have to split it up between the 4 people. So I'm just going to pretend that this is my knife cutting it up 4 ways, right? 1 way, 2 ways, 3 ways, 4 ways. When we're dividing, that's going to be represented with our original 3/4 because that's our total, 3/4 berry bread. And we're going to divide that by the 4 people that we're sharing it with. Now remember, anytime you're dividing by a whole number, we have to make it into a fraction if the other one is a fraction. So then we look at how much the top person has, which they have 1, 2, 3 pieces out of a total of how many pieces? 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. So one person is going to get 3/16 of berry bread, which I think is okay because, you know, we're going to have plenty of other food too. But we definitely want to check to make sure that even though we've already done this with the real berry bread, when we do it just with an algorithm, that it works. So remember, the rule for fractions is we have to keep the first fraction exactly the same. So we're just going to keep it as 3/4. The division sign, we're going to change it to a multiplication sign. And then for the 4/1, we have to flip it upside down and make it 1/4. Well, then it becomes a multiplication problem, which we already saw earlier. And all you have to do is multiply across, which gives us 3/16. Do they match? Yes, they do. So we are right, and we know how to divide fractions.